the action set to get underway in just a moment or two from the National Gymnastics Arena in Baku, Azerbaijan. Great to have your company for this FIG World Cup. And we will begin in a moment with the women's vault competition and men's floor exercise. We also have the men's parallel bars and steel rings and the women's uneven bars. Coming up tomorrow, we'll have the men's vault competition, the women's balance beam, women's floor, and the men's pommel horse and horizontal bar finals. So all of that coming your way over the next couple of days of FIG Artistic Gymnastics World Cup competition from the National Gymnastics Arena, a very familiar venue, and the forthcoming venue for the Rhythmic Gymnastics European Championships, which will be taking place in a couple of months in this lovely space, and indeed this lovely city. As well, we have the Rhythmic Gymnastics Junior World Championships coming up at the end of the month. They'll be taking place in Antalya in Turkey. Well below sea level on the shores of the Caspian lies the city of Baku and the nation of Azerbaijan, hosting the World Cup of Artistic Gymnastics, the third of the season. And the National Gymnastics Arena, a well-known venue in this beautiful city with its captivating old town and its lovely modern buildings, a juxtaposition living and breathing in this Silk Road trading center as we head from the east through to the west and ultimately the great city of Paris for the games of the Olympiad. And how you get there? Well, many complicated routes, many permutations. First of all, you get to the World Championships. And the World Cup competitions are a vital part of that. We've got five finals coming up for you over the next couple of hours, starting with the men's floor final, and then we'll be running pairs of finals, then parallel bars, women's vault, and then still rings and women's uneven bars in tandem. The Baku World Cup is slightly idiosyncratic in that it has the parallel bars final on the first day and the pommel horse on the second day, inversion from the traditional order of apparatus finals. Oh, that just means we'll have to wait 24 hours less to see if Ilya Kovtun can continue his extraordinary streak of winning World Cup titles in parallel bars gymnastics. Will there be joy for the host nation? They're well positioned in the men's still rings, with Nikita Simonov, one of the top performers in the qualification round. Always an enthusiastic crowd at the National Gymnastics Arena, and the competition tends to be a slickly run and quick affair, and it's going to be a great pleasure to have your company for all of the action. Ollie Hawkman here, and I'll be guiding you through the weekend of World Cup gymnastics. The AGF trophy is also part of it. It's not an International Gymnastics Federation competition. Rather, think of it as an emeritus award from the Azerbaijan Gymnastics Federation. It's given to the gymnast with the highest execution scores from the qualification process. That will also be presented today. Top-performing women and top-performing men are always awarded across all of the World Cup competitions in Azerbaijan with the AGF trophy. As I said, it's based solely on the qualification scores. So we're set to get underway in just a couple of minutes' time with the men's floor final. And we really do have some outstanding gymnasts taking part in this weekend of World Cup action, some veteran Olympic performers, some World Championship and Continental Championship performers, and names that are so familiar to those of you who watch a lot of World Cup gymnastics. We also have got some wild cards coming in, some less well-known names, some people who are virtually international debutants, and they are in some cases extremely well positioned after the qualification round. So could we see some of those less well-known names actually make it onto the podium, even win titles at the National Gymnastics Arena? I'll leave you arguing amongst yourselves about that. But it is going to be very enjoyable to discover as the competition gets underway in this rather spacious and lovely arena. Beş, dört, üç, iki, bir. Time then to begin this weekend of World Cup gymnastics. The qualifications took place on Thursday and Friday. Now only the finals remain.
Canablar, aziz dostlar, İdman Gimnastika üzere Dünya Kupası AGF Trophy yarışlarının birinci final gününe hoş gelmişsiniz.
Welcome to the first final day of the FIG Artistic Gymnastics Apparatus World Cup.
Kişi gimnastlar arasında serbest hareketlerde finalçıları karşılayın.
Please welcome men's floor finalists.
The first final will be the men's floor exercise, and here are your runners and riders, the top eight of the qualification process. And we really have got some beautiful performers on floor, some elegant and powerful gymnastics. You're looking forward to this one. It should be a cracker. Let's have a look at the eight.
Ilya Kovtun, Ukraine.
Second best in qualification, Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine. Amy Montgomery of Ireland, who won a medal in Baku last year. Nicola Bartolini, the world champion from 2021. Dom Cunningham, the European champion from 2018. Harry Hepworth, British under 18 champion and World Cup champion. Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan made the Olympic floor final. Aril Benović of Croatia, the European champion from 2020, and Riley Luz of the United States of America, Pan American Championship silver medalist last year. So how's that for a curriculum vitae of these performers in the floor final? The finalists in the men's floor competition. Top performer in qualification, Aril Benović of Croatia. He'll go penultimate in the order. He was the European champion, the silver medalist, I should say, from 2020. And we have got the world champion from 2021, Nicola Bartolini. He was the fourth best in qualification. He will go third in the order. We'll start with the second best qualifier, Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine. Warm-ups taking place for the first four gymnasts, and we have in this first half the second and fourth best qualifiers, and we have the first and third in the second half of the final. So I think it's reasonably safe to say this one will keep us guessing right the way through until the end. No Artem Dolgopi out of Israel, who regrettably is carrying an injury at the moment. We hope that that will not be unduly serious and that we'll see him back in competition as soon as possible. Thus we begin. Ukraine's Ilya Kovtun, the first to go in the men's floor competition. He was the second best in qualification, 14.233. And he'll pick up a 0.1 penalty that was not part of his qualification score. Much more secure coming out of the pike position, well landed. Got some big twisting work, gains lovely height. Good secure display this to get the final started. Lovely. Clearance in his flare work. Really impressive beginning from Ilya Kopytin in the men's floor final. 6.1, his difficulty score in qualification. The bigger difficulty scores are going to come in the second half of this final. There was a 6.2 and a 6.3 in qualification. Kopytin, the only one of the first four to post a difficulty score in excess of six. He had some issues with the opening tumbling pass, but from then on, his landings were really quite secure. There's evidence of it. Very nice piece of gymnastics from Ilya Kopytin. What kind of number will it result in? We'll see him later in parallel bars action, of course, because what would a World Cup be without Ilya Kopytin competing on parallel bars? 13.933, his execution is down by a couple of tenths from qualification. He also has that penalty, so in total, a 0.3 drop from the preliminary round. Eamon Montgomery of Ireland, 20-year-old, who won his first World Cup medal in Baku a year ago, a bronze medal. He went on to win the World Challenge Cup gold in Paris. He was the sixth best in qualification with 13.733. A very nice gymnast to watch on floor, a lovely elegance. Just had a loss of form in the air. The legs rather went in the twist position. Landing wasn't fully stable. He was a fraction low there, but it was well rescued. Really is always a pleasure to watch this young gymnast on floor. We're getting more and more accustomed to seeing him in televised finals. He was part of the Northern Ireland squad that competed at the Commonwealth Games in Birmingham in the United Kingdom last year, the first time that Northern Ireland had three gymnasts in finals at the Commonwealth Games. And you go back to a year ago and it was where it all really begun for him in this building. Starting to get used to winning international medals. With the exception of one tumbling pass, this was quite a tidy display. .766 is the score for Eamon Montgomery, .3 for going out of bounds versus a .1 in qualification, so all told he's down by close to a full mark. Nicola Bartolini of Italy, the world champion from 2021, the first Italian ever to win the title. He was fifth this year, last year I should say. 37-year-old from Sardinia. 13.966 in qualification. A gymnast for whom execution tends to win out over difficulty. And whether Nicola Bartolini wins is very dependent on those small adjustments he may or may not make on landing, because he won't have a huge difficulty cushion. but he is just such a delight in the air. His form is quite superb. Really delightful fluidity, all capped off with exquisite toe point, the ballet dancer's footwork. Oh, that's unfortunate right at the end. Took him some time to stabilize that. Now one wonders about the little landing adjustments here and there dotted around that otherwise precise display from Nicola Bartolini. Isn't he a treat to watch? Barely get the chance to see him at World Cup level. He's rather piked in his landing. Those sorts of things always look magnified. A, when you see them in slow motion, and B, when they're the final tumbling pass. 13.966 in qualification. He had the highest, or second highest, execution score of anyone. Alel Benović was marginally ahead of him. It will be interesting to see where he falls execution-wise here compared to that 8.266 from the preliminary round. So far, everyone has been down from qualification in their execution. Not just a great individual, Nicola Bartolini, but a wonderful member of the Italian team, a real leader figure for them. Second place at the European Championships. It's been an extraordinary couple of years for him in terms of his development as a gymnast. His arrival really as a top contender on the world stage. And he's proven that you can do it through execution above difficulty. There's a man who would appreciate and enjoy the AGF trophy, Nicola Bartolini. And quite a wait for his score. .433 for Nicola Bartolini. He's lost 0.3 of difficulty, and he has lost a little execution too, just over a couple of tenths. So all of that drop of just over half a mark in qualification. It means it's up for grabs for somebody. What about him? Dom Cunningham of Ireland, the European champion on floor in 2018, 7th best in qualification. Thrilled to have made this floor final with a difficulty score that I don't think is going to be representative of where he'll end up. 5.6, he's got some upgrades in store. First time he's made a World Cup final for the nation that he started representing recently, having been a member of the British squad. And what a delight it is to see the Irish squad so well represented at this World Cup. How gymnastics in Ireland has grown in the last 5 years or so. He's absolutely heading in the right direction, Dom Cunningham. Gentleman born in Birmingham, in the United Kingdom. And he is the reigning Irish all-around champion. Some nice secure tumbling work from Dom Cunningham. His execution was 8.066 in qualification, his difficulty 5.6, the joint lowest difficulty score of anyone making the final. But the way things are going in this floor final, you just never know. It could be one of those lower difficulty scores that actually gets into contention. Copton's lead is reasonably secure. 13.933. After this score, we'll have the second half of the final, the gymnast 5 through to 8 are warming up as we speak. Mentioned earlier, we still have the top qualifier to come, Karel Benovic. And there he is. European Championship silver medalist in 2020. Just outside of the top 10 at the last World Championships. 13.066 for Dom Cunningham. He's lost 0.3 of difficulty from qualification. So the scores overall are quite substantially down from the qualification process. It means that it's Copton, Bartolini and Cunningham 1, 2 and 3. Now to a young man whose difficulty scoring qualification was 6.1. He came in as the 8th best overall. Execution was the lowest of anyone making the final. Here's Harry Hepworth, a 19-year-old from Cookridge in the northwest suburbs of Leeds in the United Kingdom. Ooh, very tight going into the tuck position. Yes, he was very low coming out of that tumbling pass. Had to sit it down. And it's just lost the whole momentum, really, of the routine. He's a remarkable young man, Harry Hepworth. He was diagnosed with a hip disorder when he was 5 years old. Wasn't actually able to do any sport for 3 years until he saw a demonstration of gymnastics at his primary school. A young man came in and did a backflip, and Harry Hepworth thought, this is what I want to do. And it was gymnastics that really got him back on track, and goodness how it's got him back on track, all the way to the junior British title. So lots of promising moments in that performance from Harry Hepworth. Unfortunately, he ended up finishing quite far behind the timer. Got some very difficult work in this routine. At the moment, he's not fully in control of it. Great Britain in the luxurious position of having qualified both men's and women's teams to the Olympic Games, and being the only nation to have done that across both genders. What they can therefore do is to really enjoy these World Cups, a chance to give other gymnasts an opportunity to test themselves, to really show the strength and the depth of their squad. And for folk like Harry Hepworth, it's a great opportunity. His score, regrettably, 12.5. Execution, 6.6. He loses a little difficulty too. Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan, third best in qualification. Highest difficulty in the preliminary round, 6.3. Certainly, we've got two gymnasts coming up now who are a palpable threat to the lead of Ilya Kovtun. The first is this young man from Almaty in Kazakhstan. Purposeful beginning. He won the silver medal at the Baku World Cup last year. Had to quickly lunge backwards to stabilise that landing. He did okay. Time over rotated. No issues there. Well landed. That really is a picture perfect looking diagonal armed handstand. Now that is almost certainly going to have an impact on the leaderboard. Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan, who scored 14.233 in qualification. 13.933 is the score to beat. We have seen a trend where everybody has been lower than in qualification. Will it continue here? Has been an Asian Championship medalist on floor. That was in Mongolia in 2019. 14.2. Milad Karimi goes quite convincingly into the lead. That 6.3 difficulty score, really crucial. Now, what will we see from Aurel Benović of Croatia? 14.5 in qualification, the best score. This was a beautifully executed routine, I should say, in the preliminary round. Can he do it in the final? Well, that suggests he can. What a lovely start. Oh, he's going to be very out of bounds. Crikey, he was so off trajectory. Gets it back together with some nice pike work. The 22-year-old really did burst onto the scene when he took the silver medal at the European Championships a couple of years ago. And he has 7 World Cup medals, including 3 titles. Ooh, that's a tricky performance from Aral Benović of Croatia. Again, some real stability issues at the conclusion. He has a little chuckle to himself as he exits the competition floor. And an unusual landing for him on his second tumbling pass, well out of bounds. It was always going to be very tricky to match that high score from qualification. An 8.3 execution is not easy to achieve on a consistent basis. Bursting into almost a sheepish grin as he stabilises himself, and unfortunately it all adds up. 13.4, a 7.5 execution score, down by 0.8 and out of medal contention. So we know for certain that Milad Karimi and Ilya Kovtun are on the podium. Whether Nicola Bartolini manages to hold on or not depends on this gentleman, Riley Luce of the United States of America. 22 and the fifth best in qualification, 13.766. That would be easily enough to get him a bronze medal. He was the runner-up on floor at the Pan American Championships in Brazil last year. He's performing confidently so far. To see a bit of still rings work on floor. He has been a World Cup medalist on both floor and still rings. And he is the reigning collegiate champion on the rings. Enjoyable performance from Riley Luce of the United States of America. It could be enough to secure him his third World Cup medal. He won two medals in Copa last year. He is an undergraduate at Stanford University. He is reading management science and engineering. Well done to Riley Luce of the USA. He's taken a bronze medal and his first in the National Gymnastics Arena. Terrific performance from him. The classified results in the men's floor competition. The bronze to the USA is Riley Luce, silver to Ukraine's Ilya Kovtun, and the gold medal won by Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan. He goes one better than he did at the Baku World Cup last year. And it's his second World Cup title. We're going to get straight on with the next couple of finals now. The men's parallel bars and the women's vault to take place simultaneously. So let's have a look at the eight who've made it through to today's finals. With the men's parallel bars finalists, which is why the gymnasts are looking around and clapping. So we've just seen Ilya Kovtun, Matsuni Kazuki, Rasuljan Abdurakhimov, Dylan Jimenez, Carlos Yulo, Corin Phillips, the top qualifier, Mohamed Afifi of Egypt, and Cameron Libana of France. Rifki Fanalufi of Indonesia, Yancy Taman of Egypt, Uzbekistan's Oktana Chusovitna, Ilga Tahan of Turkey, France's Colleen Devillard, Yulin Min of the People's Republic of China, the top qualifier. First reserve coming in for Aykoda Korzdottir of Bengisi Yıldız of Turkey, and Kazakhstan's Daria Yasinskaya. Same time, the National Gymnastics Arena, women's vault and men's parallel bars, and all eyes on the top man when it comes to parallel bars gymnastics. The finalists in the men's parallel bars competition, yes, Ilya Kovtun's there, he gets us underway, but he was the third best in qualification, the top performer, Corin Phillips, of the United States of America, who's rather come out of nowhere, but he is the collegiate champion in the USA on this apparatus. And behind him, but going ahead of him in the final, Carlos Yulo of the Philippines. The finalists in the women's vault competition and the top performer in qualification, Yulin Min of the People's Republic of China. But we must keep an eye on Colleen Devillard of France, because she absolutely has the difficulty to win this final, but she struggled with her first vault in qualification. Oksana Chusovitna was the second best in qualification. To see Nancy Taman in this final. She had to withdraw from the Doha final last weekend due to injury. The first ever Egyptian woman to make a world championship final. And an absolute vault specialist. Speaking of vault specialists, Oksana Chusovitna, 47, who has competed at 17 World Championships along with her 8 Olympic Games. And she's on a fantastic run of a medal in her last 9 World Cup events. so she could make it 10 out of 10. Ilga Tarhan of Turkey, the fourth best in qualification. She won her first ever World Cup medal at home in Mersin last year, with silver on this apparatus. Now, what are we going to see in this men's parallel bars competition? Very interesting. Ilya Kovtun, who is going for his seventh consecutive World Cup title, the World Cup events that are slightly more high profile than the World Challenge Cup events. He won all four last year. He's won the first two this season, so going for seven in a row. But he was not one of the top two in qualification. Let's begin with the women's vault and men's parallel bars finals. Rifter Ivana Lutfi of Indonesia, the third best performer in qualification with a score of 12.866. Very nice vault, really secure. And her execution in qualification for both vaults was very tidy. Twisting Yurchenko is her more difficult vault. Good toe point, heels reasonably tidy at the start of the vault. Just a little loss of form in the final phase. Should be a good number for this first vault. By less than a tenth from qualification. Gymnast who's won 13 medals at the Southeast Asian Games, extraordinary record. And so she performs a pretty tidy second vault as well, Rifter Ivana Lutfi. Handspring front pike. We'll come back to her in just a moment as we head over to the men's parallel bars. Ilya Kovtun, third best in qualification, 15.066. He's going for seven World Cup golds in a row. It would be an outrageous accomplishment. It already is outrageous. Just has a little gyration there in the midsection, but he stabilised it well. So clean, performing such difficult gymnastics. Beautiful. He's a fraction overarched on that handstand, just a fraction. Not there. Lovely single rail work. Back into a central position. And as ever, an exquisite landing. He's done very well. Now, 12.566. The second vault for Rifter Ivana Lutfi. So she has set the mark that the rest are seeking to surpass, 12.799 the average. Dunansi Taman of Egypt, 12.666 average in qualification. This was the better vault. Full twisting Yurchenko. 28-year-old from the third largest city in Egypt, Alexandria. She was a Mediterranean Games vault champion in 2018. He'll certainly set the mark for everybody else, but how high will it be? She has been a World Cup champion, Nancy Taman. Her score is 13.066, higher than qualification by 0.2. Second vault from Nancy Taman could well put her into a position to go into the lead. We'll come back to it after this score for Ilya Kovtun, 15.366. He's gained 0.3 of difficulty, as he so often manages to do in a final, and that will really put pressure on the rest of the field. It's so typical of Ilya Kovtun to find that extra gear in a final. Matsumi Kazuki of Japan, fourth best in qualification, 14.966. Amazing, this 25-year-old makes his senior international debut. He is a graduate of Sendai University. Nice, stylish performance so far. Unfortunate, had to take a few paces with the hands to stabilise the overarch. Rather lost his form. Better in the Bavsar. Flicker of an overarch. Small. Lovely dismount. Backwards momentum in the pike position. So stable as he landed. Nancy Taman doesn't quite go into the lead. That 0.3 penalty for the second vault. Crucial. 12.649 has her a tenth and a half behind Rifter Ifanolutfi. Go to Oksana Chusovitna of Uzbekistan. Second best in qualification. 12.833 for the first vault. She was working hard to stabilise that big pace set out of bounds. The gymnast who is going for 10 consecutive World Cup medals. It would be quite extraordinary. She has a little more difficulty with her handspring front pike with the addition, a correction to that actually. the we'll come back to that in a moment. The score coming in for Matsumi Kazuki in a moment. Now, Oksana Chusovitina. First of all, 12.833 in qualification. Also won the Islamic Solidarity Games title last year. The second competition in a row. Well, we haven't got a score yet for Oksana Chusovitina. Now we do, 13.033, so interesting that she switched the vaults around from qualification. So that was lower by just over a tenth from the qualification performance. So Oksana Chusovitina, we'll come back to her, 14.433 for Matsumi Kazuki. He's in second position. Now to the 26-year-old from Uzbekistan, Rasul Abdurakhimov, was the top 25 performer on parallel bars at the Olympic Games in Tokyo. He just didn't quite establish his handstand position there. Only the second time we've seen him in a World Cup final. The time was in Cairo. Gentleman who received the Builder of the Future medal from the President at the conclusion of the Olympic Games. We'll come back to him as the 13.133 is the score for Oksana Chusovitina. So her difficulty upgraded by 0.4 from qualification. And that enables her to go into the lead. Now to Bilge Tarhan of Turkey. The 18-year-old vault silver medalist in her home World Cup on Mersin last year. Little twisting Yuchenko a little offline. Tidy from a landing perspective nonetheless. She scored 13 for that vault in qualification. Silver medalist at last year's national championships. First time that we've seen her competing internationally since a small exhibition event in Switzerland at the end of last year. For Bilge Tahan, very comparable from qualification, just down by a tenth, that's all. She can produce the sort of quality of which she is capable with this second vault. There's every chance she'll go into second position. Could be quite tight. Let's have a look. The second vault for Bilge Tahan of Turkey. Handspring front pike half. Now she scored 12.566 for that vault in the preliminary round. Rasuljon Abdurakhimov 14.266, exactly as he scored in qualification. Dylan Jimenez of Colombia, the fifth best in the preliminary round, 14.7. The medalist at the South American Games and the Bolivarian Games last year. He struggles a little with his single rail work and has to reset. Does get such lovely distance on his Babzar. And it sets up so nicely for that unorthodox dismount. Bilge Tahan. Is she going to manage to make her way into a provisional podium place? With four still to go. The question mark really is over Colleen Duvillard, because yes, she was the seventh best performer in qualification, but no doubt whatsoever that she can produce the numbers to win. No doubt that he can as well, but Ilya Kovtun has set quite a challenge for everyone else. She does go into second place, Bilge Tahan, 12.816, a 12.733 for that second vault, good enough to go beyond Rifta Irfana Lutfi. .266 for Dylan Jimenez. Unfortunately, he's well down from his scoring qualification. Top performer in qualification was Yulin Min. She managed to do it with an accumulated 0.4 of penalties too. If she can eliminate those, she'll be a good case to go ahead of Oksana Chusovitina, but all of that really dependent on what we see from this next Volta. Coming in as the first reserve, Bengis Yildiz. the all-around champion at the Islamic Solidarity Games last year. She also won a medal on vault. One gymnast left to warm up, that's Kazakhstan's Daria Yasinskaya. So Oksana Trusovitna has submitted to an inquiry. Come back to that. Colin Duvillard of France, the World Cup champion from Doha, seventh best in qualification here. Well, that is immeasurably better than the qualification performance. Absolutely puts her in contention. Colleen Duvillard, she struggled with her opening vault in qualifying, didn't manage to land it. A very tough decision, the trade-off with difficulty in execution, whether to go with your hardest vault. And she has found a massive improvement, 14.333 compared to 12.633. And suddenly Colleen Duvillard was well positioned to go into first place. Full twisting Yurchenko, lovely, and I think we're going to see quite a pronounced change to the leaderboard. We'll come back to that as now we go to Carlos Yulo of the Philippines over on the parallel bars. His difficulty score in qualification for 15.333 overall. beautiful. That is going to make this final really interesting. A challenge laid down to the perennial winner, Ilya Kovtun, and a clear leader in Colleen de Villar, 13.683. Her average score, she goes ahead of Oksana Chusovitina. And all of that now asks quite a lot of the Chinese gymnast, Yulin Min, who was the top performer in qualification. Just to let you know, Oksana Chusovitina's score has changed. She has got that upgrade, 13.433. Come back to that in a moment. Now, here's Yulin Min. That's way better than qualification, certainly. 13.433 was her qualification score. She's the reigning national champion on vault. There is confirmation of the change to Oksana Chusovitina's score. 4.4 upgraded to a 5.0. All of that adding 0.3 to the average score. Much better first vault, minus that 0.3 of penalty. Better looking full twisting Yurchenko as well than the qualification round for Yulin Min. Has he done it? He's done it! Carlos Yulo, 15.4. He's ended the streak of Ilya Kovtun. Extraordinary. The man who cannot be beaten has just been passed. And now to Curran Phillips of the United States of America, the top performer in qualification with a score of 15.5. He's really not even close to where he was in qualification, unfortunately, from a cleanliness perspective. Lots of little adjustments, a clip of the apparatus. It's a very difficult routine, though. He's got extraordinary complexity to his work, a 6.8 in qualification. That's a beautiful dismount as well. Interesting to see how that compares. Now, meanwhile, 13.383 into the bronze medal position goes Yulin Min. Engis Yıldız of Turkey, the all-around champion at the Islamic Solidarity Games, comes into this vault final as the first reserve. 12.866 for Bengisi Yıldız, up by 1/10 from qualification. Her second vault carried a 3.8 difficulty score in qualification, so 4/10 down from her full twisting Yurchenko. And layout Tsukahara full was what was being indicated on the vault to score, but we'll come back to that as the 14.5 for Curran Phillips comes in. And Bengisi Yıldız also was indicating a Yurchenko 1.5 for her first vault, which would have carried an extra 4/10 of difficulty, which she didn't elect to attempt. And to Mohamed Afifi of Egypt. Seventh best in qualification with a score of 14.433. It's going to be very tricky for anyone to catch Carlos Yulo at the top of the leaderboard. Just about got through that tip out with a little sense of adjustment. He's got some nice work on the parallel bars, Mohamed Afifi, the reigning all-around African champion. One to go in each of these finals. 12.583. The average score for Bengisi Yıldız. Now to Darya Yasinskaya of Kazakhstan, the last to go in the vault competition. Average of 12.599 in qualification. Well, that was nicely done. She had some difficulties in the Doha World Cup. Gets a decent amount of amplitude in the handspring front pike half vault. She was a vault finalist at the Asian Championships. That was also in Doha, where, as I mentioned earlier, she made the World Cup final last week. 12.8, so she improves by just over 1/10 from qualification. Secure from Darya Yasinskaya. Not the most difficult work that we will see at a World Cup, but well performed. 14.533. Mohamed Afifi gets his 6.0 for difficulty. And he actually goes into third position with one to go. To Cameron Lee Bernard of France. At the moment, it's Yulo, Compton and Afifi. Bernard scored 14.666 in qualification. Quite a big adjustment on the landing. Has he managed it, Cameron Lee Bernard? And where does Daria Yasinskaya finish? Sixth position for her, 12.716, a 12.633 for the second vault. So she manages an improvement on each of her vaults in the final. The final standings in the vault competition, the bronze to Yulin Min of the People's Republic of China, silver to Oksana Chusovitna of Uzbekistan, 10 World Cup medals in a row for her, and Colin Devillard of France wins her second World Cup title in the space of a week with a much improved performance from qualification. Cameron-Lee Bernard has gone into third place. He is absolutely thrilled about it as well. Celebrates with Colin Devillard. Just comes in ahead of Mohamed Afifi. These are the final results in the men's parallel bars competition. Cameron-Lee Bernard of France takes the bronze medal. Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine takes silver. His remarkable streak of six World Cup titles in a row comes to an end courtesy of Carlos Yulo, and it was by a fraction. Such a close contest, and Compton finally is beaten. In a moment we'll bring you some victory ceremonies. on we go. More gymnastics in Baku, Azerbaijan. The women's uneven bars and the men's still rings finals. So these are the contenders for still rings glory. Mehmet Kursak of Turkey, Carlos Yulu of the Philippines, Mahdi Ahmad Kohani of Iran, Nguyen Phang Han Phong of Vietnam, Ling Guanyi from Chinese Taipei. Big reaction for Nikita Simonov of Azerbaijan. Special moment for him. He's the top qualifier. Vincent Herc of Austria and Riley Luz of the United States of America. And now to the women's uneven bars finalists, Filipa Martins of Portugal, Aitor Tozdottir of the Netherlands, Sevgi Kaysolo of Turkey, top qualifier Chu Chi Yuen of the People's Republic of China, Ruby Pass of Australia, Sanna Veerman of the Netherlands, Georgia Vila from Italy, and Georgia Rose Brown of Australia. To have your company for all of the action from Baku's National Gymnastics Arena. Two finals left to come. How nice to see Aitor Tozdottir back at the World Cup. The finalists in the rings competition, the top performer in qualification, Azerbaijan's own Nikita Simonov. He goes sixth in the order. He won a bronze medal at the World Cup in Doha last week. Second best in qualification was Mahdi Ahmad Kohani. He's the third to go. And right after him, the third best in qualifying, Nguyen Phang Han Phong of Vietnam. And he was seventh in this competition a year ago. The finalists in the women's uneven bars competition in Baku. Chu Chi Yuen of the People's Republic of China, the top performer in qualification, seeking to move on from a really disappointing senior international debut in Doha, where she was the top qualifier for bars and came off three times in the final. It's a great routine if it all comes together. Second best in qualification was Georgia Vila. She'll go seventh in the order. And one before her, the third best in qualification, the Netherlands' Sanna Veerman. Wouldn't it be some story if this gentleman can get onto the podium? 20-year-old Nguyen Phang Han Phong of Vietnam. Only his second World Cup final ever, this. He's a very nice gymnast on the rings. He's always been just a little below the radar, not quite making finals. But he's a pleasure to watch. Time to begin the still rings final with Mehmet Kursak, 22-year-old from Turkey. sixth time he's been in a World Cup final. He was the fourth best in qualification. He's yet to make it onto a World Cup podium, but he has won a European Championship medal in team competition. Branch down into the Maltese, worked well. Yamawaki Yonison to Maltese. He's making just little adjustments here and there. Good shoulder line. His handstand work is quite tidy. And again, this has gone well. It's gone pretty convincingly. Mehmet Kürsak of Turkey has started this final in, I would say, rather commanding fashion. Felipe Martins of Portugal, eighth best in qualification, 12.933. The reigning national champion and the bronze medalist at the Mediterranean Games. She's got some nice work on this apparatus. Interesting skills we don't see from a huge number of gymnasts. Oh, wasn't that nicely performed? Felipe Martins, as the score is 14.233 for Mehmet Kürsak, exactly as he performed in qualification. Carlos Yulo of the Philippines. Fifth best in qualification. He's just won that fantastic parallel bars title. Got tremendous physical control. Gets the knees in so tightly, as Yamawaki. And the pipe work in the Yonison is so elegant in contrast. Differentiates between his skills so beautifully. Well, there may be more difficult work, there will be more difficult work to come in this final, but in terms of a sense of style, it's hard to top Carlos Yulo. Very nice to watch. ...12.9 for Felipe Martins. Execution better than in qualification, but difficulty down a fraction. To Aitora Thorsdottir of the Netherlands. Fourth best in qualification, 13.533. Just a little adjustment in the overshoot. Amiga was quite fluidly performed. And she dismounts wonderfully. Oh, very nice from Aitora Thorsdottir. So seldom get the chance to see her at a World Cup, as we have confirmation on that 12.9 for Filipa Martins. 14.166 for Carlos Yulo. The first two scores in this rings final have been exactly the same as qualification. Mahdi Ahmad Kohani. .5 in scoring qualification, the second best. He won the silver medal in Cottbus. Starts with the planche position into a very elegant Maltese. That's beautiful. And again, really nice. That little opening up of the palms is so stylish. Very high planche. He does adjust a little, but convincing. A nice shoulder presentation too, good line. Looks very assured, this 25-year-old. Snapped beautifully into handstand. And he dismounts quite well with a little adjustment, but on the whole, that is very pleasing gymnastics. 13.566 for Aitora Thorsdottir, whose only World Cup medal was won in Ljubljana in Slovenia in 2015. She won the floor title right at the start of her senior career. Sevgi Kayasolo of Turkey, 13.033 in qualification. She really produced a lovely routine. Gets nice height in her Mike Jaeger somersault. And dismounts really elegantly as well. On the subject of elegance, a lead for Mahdi Ahmad Kohani, 14.5. I can't remember the last time the first three scores in a final were all exactly the same as qualification. Very consistent performance. To Nguyen Phang Han Phong of Vietnam, 14.233 in qualification. 20-year-old from Ho Chi Minh City. He was 12th last week in Doha. He was 12th at the World Championships in 2021. So we've so often nearly seen him in big televised finals. you'll enjoy this. Isn't that a level Maltese? He really gets his shoulders level with the rings too. There's a flicker from the midsection in the planche that requires readjustment. Namawaki to Jonasson to Maltese. That's difficult. He's got some yawing of the rings to contend with. Well stabilized. To contend, this dismount is going to have to be absolutely spot on. The handstands are nice. How's the landing? Oh, it's good. Very small pace. 12.966 for Sevgi Kayasolo. Not quite as strong as qualification, but she's in second position after the first three. Well, you really do wish her well. Chu Chiwen of the People's Republic of China, top qualifier for the second week in a row, 14.766. But as I mentioned earlier, she came off three times in Doha in the final. That's nice, the downy. The Pak Solto. This is looking infinitely better than it did in the final week ago. Oh, how nice to see. Well done, Chu Chiwen. What a transformation from a week ago. She's only 15. 14.366. The young man from Vietnam has gone into the silver medal position ahead of Carlos Yulo and ahead of Mehmet Kosak. So at the halfway mark, Mahdi Ahmad Kohani of Iran leads, then Nguyen Phang Han Phong of Vietnam in second place, Mehmet Kosak of Turkey in third. Over on the bars, I thought Thor Dottir is handsomely in the lead. Sevgi Solo and Felipe Martins. We'll wait for the score for Chu Chiwen, which will probably change all of that. Young Australian Ruby Pass will start the second half of the final. Another 15-year-old. There will be a lot of reaction for him. Nikita Simonov. Yes. 14.7, that's the routine she came to perform, and boy, she's performed it. And it likely has ended the race for gold in this final. From a still rings standpoint, we have quite a close race for the medals, but rings tends to be very close, and so much tends to come down to the tidiness of the landing. And Nikita Simonov is going to need that if he is to surpass Mahdi Ahmad Kohani. In contrast, over on the uneven bars, it's Chu Chiwen at a canter. Lin Guanyi of Chinese Taipei. A 22-year-old who won a silver medal at the Mersin World Challenge Cup last year. University student at the Taipei University of Education. A little low in his Maltese, perhaps. No problems there. Beautiful iron cross. Then maybe a little high in the legs in the planche. Not always easy to tell from this sort of angle. The judges have the perfect view. And listen to Yamawaki. Better Maltese that time. Really has a nice looking iron cross position. Good to see him in this final, Lin Guanyi. He didn't make it into the final at the last two World Cups in Doha and Cottbus. Last warm-up, finishing over on the uneven bars, Georgia Rose Brown of Australia. And then it will be the turn of her teammate, Ruby Pass. Goes into third place, Lin Guanyi, 14.233, an increase of 0.2 in qualification. Well, it's a bit of a high-pressure moment for Nikita Simonov of Azerbaijan, but he has won medals in this place already. He took bronze at the World Cup last year. He comes as the top qualifier, 14.733. The highest difficulty of anybody in the qualification process. It's a big straddle planche, it's a little diagonal, but it's well executed. That's a nice level looking Maltese by contrast. Very slightly overarched in his handstand, but it's a difficult skill. He does go into that Maltese position so nicely. Iron cross is secure as well. Slightly bent in the midsection going into the straddle planche, but rescued. Crucial dismount to come for Nikita Simonov of Azerbaijan. Here he goes. It's very well performed to the delight of the volunteers watching on. Nikita Simonov of Azerbaijan. Of Australia. Sixth best in qualification. Maloney. That's a nice capture variation. That's in the half turn this time of Van Loven. Really good developing gymnast is Ruby Pass of Australia. Exciting to see her starting to come through and appear at senior international level in finals. Nikita Simonov is likely to go into the lead. And he has done, 14.633. The arena presenter is reasonably pleased about that, based on the booming voice that is echoing around probably the whole of the city. He goes ahead of Matty Ahmad Kohani. Vincent Herc of Austria. Now he does have the potential to get up there and challenge, but in qualification it was not the cleanest of performances, 8.1 his execution for 14.1 in total. A deliberate movement, slow, showing control. Into Yamawaki to a Maltese that just about keeps its axis. Lovely level line. Oh, crisp handstand, that was just beautiful. It was a very good dismount as well from Vincent Herc. Now, how close is he going to get? Watching on, Ruby Pass has gone into second place, 13.633. She looks utterly thrilled about that, as well she might. Sanne Veerman of the Netherlands. Her scoring qualification was 13.7. Straddle Jaeger, cleanly performed. This time into the hiked version. The catcher, I should say, on that occasion. Oh, there's the Bardwage. Lovely. Van Leuven, lots of difficult work. A good performance from Sanne Veerman of the Netherlands, the 21-year-old who won a silver medal last year at the World Cup in Cottbus. Now, what score for Vincent Herc? 14.1 in qualification. And he's gone into third place, 14.433, much improved in terms of execution, it certainly looked like it. So it is Nikita Simonov, then Madi Ahmad Kohani and Vincent Herc. So he's displaced Nguyen Phan Hang Phong. With one to go, Riley Luce of the United States of America. Bronze medalist on rings at the Pan American Championships last year. And he is the reigning NCAA champion, the college gymnastics champion in the USA. Gosh, he really does get his arms to horizontal there. straddle lever. Nice transition into the Maltese position. Lovely level Maltese. What a good routine from Riley Luce of the United States of America. His dismount, one of the best that we've seen. And Sanna Veerman, 13.766. She goes into second place. And now we have got the second strongest in qualification to come. Giorgia Vila of Italy, 13.9. in the preliminary round. What a nice catch here to open. Oh, that's a delightful looking bardage. Tandy van Leuven too, she's got real strength and swingfulness. That's a wonderful performance from Giorgia Vila of Italy. Never won a World Cup medal. The only time she's actually competed in a World Cup was at the Milwaukee World Cup in 2020, an all-around World Cup. 14 for Riley Luce. 5.7 his difficulty, but very nicely executed. The classified results in the men's still rings competition. The bronze medal to Austria's Vincent Hoek. The silver to Mati Ahmad Kohani of Iran. And the title won at home by Nikita Simonov of Azerbaijan. Certainly expected Giorgia Vila to improve upon her qualification score, and she has done. She goes into second place with a score of 14, and she's just guaranteed herself her first ever World Cup medal. Xu Qiwen leads, then Giorgia Vila, then Sanna Veerman. What a great uneven bars final it's been. One left. To feel for young Ruby Pass, who's just been nudged off the podium, but nudged off the podium by some really high quality work. Her own work was extremely good. Georgia Rose Brown of Australia, fifth best in qualification, 13.5, an increase of almost 0.3 required to get onto the podium. Stolda Shaposhnikova to transition to a Maloney. She executes the Ginga somersault, has to build the swing back up. Big work in the piped Jaeger. And a nice dismount from Giorgia Rose Brown. What a great finish to this uneven bars final. Last piece of gymnastics that we'll see on this first day of competition in Baku. The gymnast who is a postgraduate in her doctoral studies at the University of Melbourne. She needs to get beyond 13.766 to make it onto the podium. That's Sanna Veerman. She's certainly giving it a very good go, Georgia Rose Brown. And she is very close, 13.633, fourth position for Georgia Rose Brown of Australia. Improved from qualification, just not quite enough. The classified results in the uneven bars final. The bronze to the Netherlands and Sanna Veerman, silver to Italy's Georgia Vila, and the gold medal to Chu Chi-Yuen of the People's Republic of China. But an honourable mention to the two Australians at very different stages of their careers, Georgia Rose Brown and Ruby Pass. Great performances from them to come very close to taking a medal. Well, we now have the victory ceremonies for the five competitions that have just taken place to bring you. So don't go too far away. We'll have the celebrations from the National Gymnastics Arena in Baku in just a moment or two.
Hanımlar ve cənablar, mükafatlandıran mərasiminə başlayırıq.
Ladies and gentlemen, we proceed with award ceremony. Please welcome the medalists.
The victory ceremony for the men's floor exercise.
Award ceremony for men's floor exercise final. Third place and bronze medalist, Riley Luce, United States of America.
The winner of the bronze
second
medal,
place,
Riley Luce of the United States of America.
Ilya Kovtun, Ukraine.
His third World Cup honours for Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine,
place.
The silver medal.
And gold medalist, Milad Karimi, Kazakhstan.
And the title goes to Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan, his second World Cup title.
Mr. Rauf Aliyev, deputy of Azerbaijani.
And what a nice moment for Ilya Kovtun, getting to 25 World Cup medals.
Galib ve mükafatçılara hediyeler LG şirket tarafından takdim oldu.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and show your
and now the national anthem of
national
Kazakhstan.
Anthem of Kazakhstan.
Tebrik ederik.
Congratulations.
The medalists in the men's floor competition in Baku. Victory ceremony in the women's vault
İdman
competition.
İdman Gimnastik Dünya Kubokunda kadın gimnastların dayağı kullanmada mükafatlandırılmasına başlayırız.
Award ceremony for women's vault final. Third place and bronze medalist Oksana Chusovitina, Uzbekistan.
I think they might have got that one wrong. Just wait for a moment. Because it is Yulin Min who has won the bronze medal. Colin de Villars is having a right old chuckle in the centre of the podium.
Third place and bronze medalist, Yulin Min, China.
The winner of the bronze medal, Yulin Min from the People's Republic of China.
Second place and silver medalist,
first ever
Oksana
World Cup honours for her.
Uzbekistan.
Oksana Chusovitina of Uzbekistan takes the silver medal,
first
winning
place
her 10th
gold medalist,
World
Colin
Cup
de
medal
Villard,
in a row.
France.
And Colleen de Villars of France takes the title, just as she did a week ago in Doha. A much improved performance from qualification, where she
the
was the seventh best. But she was
Mr.
always
Emma
a contender
Esami,
for the title,
of African
and she won it well.
Union and Egyptian Gymnastics Federation.
Hediyeler LG şirket tarafından takdim olunur.
Please stand and show your respect.
Now the national anthem of France.
Anthem of France.
Tebrik ederik.
Congratulations.
Medalists in the women's vault competition. And on we go with more presentations. As the victory ceremonies continue. Next, the men's parallel bars final.
İdman Gimnastik Üzeri Dünya Kubokundaki kişi gimnastların paralel kollardan bir atlandırmasına başlayalım.
Award ceremony for men's parallel bars final. Third place and bronze medalist Cameron Lee Bernard, France.
A lovely moment for Cameron Lee Bernard, France,
second
as he gets his first World Cup honours.
Ilya Kovtun, Ukraine.
Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine is still on the podium. But his remarkable winning streak was ended.
Carlos Adriel Yulo, Philippines.
And it was ended by that gentleman, Carlos Yulo of the Philippines. A fantastic victory, just by a matter of hundreds ahead of Ilya Kovtun.
Show your respect.
And now the national anthem of the Philippines.
Tebrik ederik.
Congratulations.
The medalists in the men's parallel bars competition at the National Gymnastics Arena in Baku.
İdman Gimnastik Üzeri Dünya Kubokunda kadın gimnastlara müxtəlif
Award
ceremony for women's uneven bars final. Third place and bronze medalist Sanna Veerman, Netherlands.
Sanna Veerman of the Netherlands winning the bronze medal.
Georgia Villa, Italy.
A first ever World Cup medal for Italy's Georgia Villa.
First place and gold medalist Qian Qiu, China.
And this time, it's all so different from a week ago. Zhu Qiyuan of the People's Republic of China winning the title.
Technical delegate.
How lovely to see from this young gymnast. Massive character. Real resilience after so much disappointment in Qatar. In her second international competition, she takes a gold medal. And we'll now have the national anthem of China.
Tebrik ederik.
Congratulations.
The medalists in the women's uneven bars competition in Baku. Ceremony for the men's still rings competition.
İdman Gimnaz Gazı Dünya Kubokunda kişi gimnastların halgalarda mükafatlandırılmasına başlayırız.
Award ceremony for men's rings final. Third place and bronze medalist Vincent Hook, Austria.
The winner of the bronze medal, Vincent Hook of Austria.
Second place and silver medalist Mahdi Ahmad Kohani, Islamic Republic of Iran.
The winner of the silver medal, Mahdi Ahmad Kohani
First
of Iran.
Place and gold medalist.
Birinci yer ve kızıl medalçı Nikita Sivanov, Azerbaijan.
And the winner of the gold medal, Azerbaijan's Nikita Sivanov.
The medals are presented.
Lovely moment
by
for him,
Mr.
winning
Fabian
a home
Aimbov,
World
Minister
Cup title.
Youth and Sport of the Republic of Azerbaijan. Gentlemen, please stand and show
national
your
anthem
respect
of
for
the host nation,
anthem
Azerbaijan.
Of the Republic of Azerbaijan.
Muhteşem destek! Tebrikler Azerbaycan! Güzel bir daha Azerbaycan! Teşekkürler size tebrikler! Bir daha görmüşler! İkincisi de Azerbaycan için ve sizler için! Kendinize payınız var!
The medalists in the men's rings competition at the World Cup in Baku, Azerbaijan. And we have still to come the presentation of the AGF trophy. Along in just a moment.
Aziz dostlar, yarışlarda ən yüksək icra xalı toplamış kişi və qadın gimnast təşkilatçılar tərəfindən AGF trofi ilə təltif olunur.
Man and woman gymnasts with the highest execution score are awarded with AGF trophy. Please welcome men gymnast Nicola Bartolini, Italy.
Now great surprise that Nicola Bartolini
and
wins the AGF trophy.
Rifta Ifanalutfi, Indonesia.
And Indonesia's Rifta Ifanalutfi. Two winners of the AGF trophy for the highest execution score in the qualification process.
Tebrik ederik.
Congratulations.
And all of that brings to a close our coverage of the first day of competition from the National Gymnastics Arena in Baku, Azerbaijan. It's been a great pleasure having your company. I've been Ollie Hopman, and I hope to have your company again tomorrow for five more finals. Until then, goodbye, but not farewell.
Aziz dostlar, bununla da birinci final günü sona çatdı. Sabah hamınızı ikinci final gününde gözləyəcəyik.
Dear friends, first final day is over. We'll see you tomorrow at the last final day of this World Cup.
Dünya Kubokunda artık üçüncü yarış gördü. Bugün de...
İki de sırada birinci değil ama...